Hello, hello everyone. Welcome. If you've never been here to my small knitting podcast on YouTube, welcome back if you've already been here. My name is Isabelle. I'm from France. I have three sons. I have three cats. Some say it's related. And I'm bringing you this podcast in English because I used to live in the United States, but that was 30 years ago and my talking English is gone. And this is a way for me to practice my English at least once a week. My talking English at least once a week. So on my YouTube channel, I have two series. One is a regular knitting podcast on my knitting adventures and what I knit and what I buy and my projects and everything. And the second series is one I will have, I'm filming today. It's about woolly news, the news in the fiber and knitting and crocheting community that have caught my attention over the last 2 weeks because I'm posting every other week and I'm alternating the two series. Both series are in a playlist. Each series has its own playlist down below. And as always, I try to fill the description box. Usually I have to cut out what I put because there is a character limit on the YouTube description boxes. So I have also one or several blog posts that are related to what I'm currently talking about. For the Woolly News series, I usually have only one blog post with all the pictures and all the links and everything that I can't put in my description box. So if this sounds good to you, please stay tuned. Okay, so today it's a woolly news series. I have notes in front of me. This is why I'm, you know, sometimes being looking down. The first news I want to talk about, and this is something I wanted to talk about for a long time, but, you know, it got pushed aside and I'm not sure why. It's about a designer. She's Vicky Perkins. I hope I'm not butchering her name too much. And she releases only three patterns, and all of her patterns are really amazing. The first time I saw a pattern from her, or maybe the first time one pattern caught my attention, was with these coils that have sort of a medieval look. Color work, and I'm really amazed that everything she releases is for free, because I think it's a lot of work to write up patterns like that, and they are well written, and just the color work that she offers, all the different patterns and calls she has are extremely beautiful. And I think if you have some either leftovers, or if you have been subscribed, or if you bought some kind of an advent calendar for yarn, I didn't, this maybe would be a very good way to use it. She offers, usually her pictures are with two colors, most of them, but I'm sure you can work some kind of fade in the color work, and that would be very nice. And a few podcasts ago, I talked about some leftovers I had from my shawl. And of course, I just because I want to talk about it, I do not recall the name of it's my memory. Don't get old, my memory. I'm gonna find it right away. My elven shawl, you know, I did not even have to look to my notes, but my elven shawl, I have some leftovers from Cocon Yarns. I knitted it with. It was the recommended yarn and a gift from my sons last Christmas, last year. So I wanted to knit some mitts with the leftovers. I've talked about the meats and I have one pattern in mind. I have in one in my books. But, you know, as I was looking through things, notes I had, and I was thinking, so what have I already talked about and I can get rid of, and what is it left? Vicky's pattern popped up, and I was maybe thinking to use my leftovers from my elven shawl with one of her patterns. I won't have enough, for a two color work. So I may use several colors. Anyway, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with these leftovers, because now I have two projects in mind. I'll let you know. And I don't think I have enough to make at the same time the meats and the coals. But anyway, please have a look at her patterns. They are amazing. Some of them are just really stunning. And all of them are free. So I think you should have a look and maybe consider knitting one of them, and maybe with one of your advents. Next is, I've already talked about that already. I just showed, she had only a preview of what the pattern was going to be, and it had no name yet. Now it's out and it has a name. It's the Avena sweater from Jennifer Steinglass. Steinglass, yes, I hope I'm not butchering your name too much. She is Knit Love Wool everywhere. Knit.love.wool. So she released the pattern. I bought it because I have a project in mind. I have yarn here for it, so I bought the pattern. One thing I had not noticed the first time around, and now seeing all the test knitters, all the projects that have already been knitted, you can have a fade in the color work that has some kind, probably, I do not recall. I think she's talked about it, about the leaves she's been using for the color work. It's called Avena, so maybe it's what it is. But anyway, you can have a fade in the leaves, in the sticks that you are knitting, with a darker color at the top and a lighter color at the bottom. Some people have used, I guess, safe-changing color yarn. Okay, so my lady cat wants to go out, so I will let her out, and I'll be back right after I've let her out. Okay, she's out. I have two boys and one lady cat. She's the oldest. All of them are rescues. She doesn't like the boys very much. She just accepts to share the house with them. They sometimes play a little rough. The two boys play a little rough together, but she doesn't play with them and they don't come to play with her. She doesn't like it. So anyway, when they are out, one of my last baby cat, he's 3.5 years old, so he's not a baby anymore. He almost never goes out, but the other one, who is seven, or six, is out all the time, and you know, they come back to it, and I think they share their territories. They are not together outside. Anyway, the Avena sweater, and some people have done amazing color fades, so either fades or self striping yarn. I do not know, but I did not look closely enough, sorry. But I think it's a very good idea. I think I have something, I have yarn here to knit it. It's a very beautiful pattern. And, you know, I encourage you to have a look, and maybe if you have some yarn in your stash to cast it on. Okay. Next, it's about knit along. And or I guess I'm not sure. I talked about Lambianemis Nitelong last time, I think. So it's one Nitelong from Ansu On, Lisa, who has also a very lovely YouTube podcast here on YouTube, and very lovely. And I think when I watch her, I think we have a lot of in common. We like the same things. She sews. I don't. My mother was a. I'm not sure how you call that. Her work was to make clothes for a company, and she used to make all the clothes for us. And she taught me. But even though I know sewing is faster than knitting, you can have a garment very quickly, especially if you use a sewing machine and a good one. My mother had a good one. She still has. She quilts and everything, and she quilts by hand. And now she uses the sewing machine because it's a bit difficult for her. But anyway, she taught me, and sewing is not my thing. I don't envision all the pieces together. It's difficult for me. I do not like using the sewing machine. Sewing by hand is tedious and not as strong. So, and I was very much more into knitting when I was young. My grandmother taught me. She has a part of her podcast is for knitting, part of her podcast is for sewing. I think she designs also. I will have to check, but I you know, the few sewing podcasts, you know, I usually skip that. She was using either Pedfor or Free Patterns for garments, so I do not know if she designs some of herself. But anyway, she's currently having a knit along in partnership with another YouTuber, and I'm not sure I have her name. I will write her name here, who she's partnering with. I will link to her channel, and you will have all the information in the description box. What interested me in this knit along, I do not know whether I'm gonna do it or not, but is for new things that you have never been doing before, you know, something new and for the first time. I like this idea very much because it's a way to encourage you to venture in new areas you've never been venturing into, and maybe, you know, find something that is not a very heavy and long project, a smaller piece, but where you can use new techniques you've never been using before. So I have several techniques that are waiting for me, for me to try on. The first one is brioche. I've never been knitting brioche. I'm very old, so before brioche we had other stitch patterns that kind of have the same feel of it. One of them is a rib stitch where you knit one every other stitch from the row below, and then you have a double layer of yarn, so it's also very stretchy, very bouncy and very warm, same way brioche is. It's another technique. So I need to try that. I've never. I have several patterns I can choose from. I may. The second technique I have never used is sticking. It makes me quite afraid. It's making me quite afraid of it. I've watched a lot of video about sticking, because I'm very much interested into this technique. I like the idea to knit in the round and stick a garment to make a cardigan, for example. But one thing I like also is knitting in pieces, because this is how I have always done. I've been knitting in the round you know, for the last few years when I found Ravelry and all this world. That was maybe 4 years ago when I had a burnout at work and I took knitting back. It came back into my life. So I discovered about knitting in the round. But I like when you knit in pieces, the structure it gives to a garment on the shoulders and around the arms, sometimes also around the collar. And I don't find that very much into the patterns that are knit in the round. And for example, this is why I like the Lorentzen sweater very much, because you start with, I do not recall, I think it's the front. You knit a part of the front, then you knit part of the back. You pick up stitches and you knit part of the back, or you keep them live. I don't recall. I think you pick them up. And then you pick up stitches for the sleeves. And that gives structure, that where the seams hold the garment in place more than when you knit in the round. And especially if the yarn is a bit mellow and a bit, you know, it doesn't hold by itself, it's not rustic enough to hold by itself. And I prefer structured garments. So knitting a cardigan in the round and sticking it, I'm not sure this is what I would like. But anyway, sticking, there are other pieces that you can, there is, I saw, I think, a shawl that you stick, you know, rather than knitting back and forth, you knit in the round and you stick it. So why not? Maybe I could try that. But that's something I have to adventure myself into. And so these are the two techniques that maybe could be a first for me. One thing also, I've knitted only once. I did not write the pattern down. My grandmother, I was less than 10 years old. I was knitting socks with her. I've never been knitting socks since then. So I would just knit with her and come to see her whenever I was, you know, starting it up, because we usually knit from the toe up. Starting at the start, the heel, and then after I was on my own for all the rest. And I did not write a pattern and I was just following. She would say, do this, do that, and I would do it. And it would make a pair of socks for me or for my friends. So I did maybe a third thing to go back, you know, to is knitting socks. Okay, so these are three ideas. Maybe there are other ideas you can have. Maybe we can share down below. About something that would be a first for you and to join this camp. One other thing that makes me think I'm not sure I will enter is that it ends up at February 1st. It's a short time for me. For me, it's a short time because I have a full-time job and this job is taking back again a lot of my time, more than it has since this summer, because I had a big change in my work last year. So it, you know, it's growing back again, being very, very, very full time and sometimes more than full time. So just 1 month, it's gonna be a bit difficult for me. A 1 year long call, why not? Because I don't like pressure, I don't like deadlines. Some people like that, I do not, for my knitting. I have pressures and deadlines all day long at work. So my knitting is for me. And I don't know if I will enter. I will leave all the details down below, but I thought it was a very, very interesting idea. Okay, next, it's once again about La Bien-Aimée. She's so productive right now, it's incredible, and to my pleasure. So she's launched a subscription call for a new book, and I'm gonna pause now because I've forgotten something that I want to bring here when I'm talking about that, and I will go and get it. Okay, I had a very hard time finding it because I filmed a few days ago a video with where I was showing all my stash and at the starting point for my yarn no buy year for next year, and I put back everything together and it was very well back together and I could not find it. So anyway, I found it. So La Bien-Aimée is gonna, she has a subscription, not a, a submission call for a new book that will come out next fall. And the idea is to have patterns that feature different yarn bases. And I thought this idea was a very good idea because I was already in my mind for things I have in my stash thinking about doing this. And in particular, what she's gonna be looking for is an association of her yarns with some other brands or yarn producers. So different textures and everything. What caught my attention about that, and I am in no way a designer. I've never came up with a pattern other than knitting something on the go like that for myself. But you know, I'm knitting my yellow mohair sweater with this yellow color that is making me so happy. And I will have enough yarn, I think, for a second sweater. And when I bought the yarn for my son's Christmas at the Fonti, Filature Fonti, the Fonti mill, and you know, this video, I'm not sure when it's gonna be up, maybe next week, maybe the week after next. I'm very busy this week, and I will be the next few weeks, 2 weeks, because my sons are back home. This is their, what they call the sari yarn. I'm not sure it's even yarn. It's a thread that is made with recycled saris from India. I picked up, you know, whatever first color batch was there because they are all one of a kind. And without, you know, first to see what it was like, and second to see if I wanted to knit something with it. The association of the two popped in my mind when I received it. This rustic, coarse, and bigger thread with the fine, fluffy mohair. And, you know, you haven't seen the video yet, but when you see it, I'm talking about making some kind of color work in the yoke, but a very simple one, because with mohair, it's not always very easy. Just stripes, for example, or I maybe have to think about something else. And what interested me into Stephen West's shallography is the first clue. You have what I don't have the pattern, so I think is some kind of either garter or reverse stockinette. I think it's reverse stockinette from what I've seen. That is protruding, that is making, that is higher on the knit, on the fabric, than the background, which is regular stockinette. And I was thinking about doing this with these two that are very different in look, very different in feel. Some common colors here that you can see. But yeah, when she talked about that, she talked about it in her mailing list. So in her newsletter, so that's one good reason for you to subscribe if you haven't already. It really popped in, you know, it jumped at me once again, because it's something I wanted to do for myself. So I will at some point. But if you have an idea and a pattern to submit, you should do it by January 10th. So it's coming up quite quickly. And speaking of La Bien-Aimée, I will move next to the, you know, books section, and about her worsted yellow book, yellow as the cover, you know. She will be offering translations in French and Japanese. French most probably by February next year, and Japanese by next spring. And she will have a second print for the English version sometime the end of the winter. So that's probably going to be early 22 also. And spring 2022 for a second print. And the erratas that have been published. And when I received my book, I had a little flyer into it for the errata, will be incorporated in the book itself. But most of all, when this video is going to be up, because we are on the 15th, when I have a bit of time to film that, that video. So I'm going to put it up automatically on next Friday. So that's the 19th. And she will have a knit night that night. So that's tonight or wherever you're seeing that video, and if you are, you know, Western from me, you will see it probably in your morning, and the knit night is going to be around noon, 2 o'clock in the afternoon for you, and if you are east from me, the knit night is even going to be even later, because it's 7 p.m. in Paris night. It's a virtual knit night. And I did enjoy her previous knit night very, very, very much. And I hope I can join this knit night too. And my last news, it's not my last news, but it's another news about a book. And usually, you know, I will show in my knitting adventures my own acquisitions. So I received the Worsted book last week, so I will talk about it next time in my knitting adventures. But this book I want to talk here in the news, because it's a very special book to me. It's Knitting for Radical Self-Care, A Modern Guide by Brandi Cheyenne Harper. You know, you can find it everywhere books are sold. You can, you know, she has a website, and I will try to link everything down below, and so with the ISBN, and you can, you know, find it wherever it's close to you. What interested me, it's not that much the patterns, or she, you know, she has also techniques, and it's always good to have somewhere, but it's the radical self-care part of it, and how she can associate knitting small stitches with meditation. And it's something that I use knitting for, self-relief, self-care. Maybe it's a bit too much for me, self-care. Maybe I need to be doing more self-care about myself. But anyway, that's what caught my attention. It's a very beautiful book. You have very beautiful patterns, mostly with bigger, chunkier yarns. You have, you know, sweaters and cardigans and shawls and coats and all of that. Very interesting. And I encourage you to have a look, because it's a very, very good book to read, not only, you know, for patterns and techniques and stuff like that, but also for her own take on knitting and, you know, what is the place of knitting in her life. So I was very, very much interested into the book. And I do not know whether I'm going to knit or not, but I'm reading it, and I'm reading it and over and over and over. You know, it's a companion. It's a companion book more than a recipe book. And a book for self-reflecting on your own life, and maybe what place knitting is into your life, and what place caring, self-caring is into your life. And it's a very, very interesting book. I like her view on, you know, life and everything. So I like her angle of view. It's a different angle of view from what my own, and I like to be pushed a bit sideways, out of my own comfort zone, and she does that. So you should have a look if this is something that is interesting to you. So my last news for today, it's about notions. So if you're located in France or in Europe, you may have seen, I did not talk about it because I could not attend any of the virtual events that were there, and it was a bit at a time where I had a lot of work, and anyway, I did not talk about it, but there was a festival in Lyon, and that was the Knit It festival. So every year they do that, apparently. So they release a booklet with patterns every year for this occasion. And they also released stitch markers. They are just adorable. And they're very nice. It's like little sweaters with color work and patterns. Very nice little stitch markers. If my sons ever ask me what I would like for as a Christmas present, I will tell them that. They're very, very nice, very, you know, sweet little things. They have pins too on the same idea. It's very, very adorable stitch markers. And I will leave the website link down below. I haven't checked if they ship internationally, but I would think they would ship at least in Europe. And so for you to have a look, they have other things, including the, you know, pattern books I talked about. But they are very, very nice and cute little stitch markers. And, I've ordered already a lot of stitch markers. I have Coco Knits, and I have some from Steven West, the triangular ones. That fit on my bigger needles, so I'm not looking at now to buy stitch markers. I have enough, but you know, for a Christmas wish list, that could be a good idea. Okay, my friends, so here we are. I do not have anything else to add for today. Thank you for watching and listening to me. Please subscribe if this is what I'm offering is of some interest to you, and ring the bell so that you get notified whenever I upload something. And also, especially in these times that I think out around us are not getting better, please actively place happiness in your life. Find happiness, and maybe your knitting will bring you some happiness, and actively place it in your life, because it's not going to come all by itself, by, you know, automatically. So place happiness in your life, happy knitting, and take care of yourself, and I will see you next time. Thank you.